When I visited University of Maryland, I really felt this sense of people knew each other and cared about each other, but you could also do your own thing. So it was, there was a friendliness, there was community, but it wasn't stifling. I've met so many awesome people here and been challenged in ways that I couldn't imagine. I just finished my first year, and so my research is just starting, but I was able to do an end of semester project for an operations research methods and engineering class I took through mechanical engineering. So I was focusing on fortification decisions on Nepal's road network. So given various situations that might occur in Nepal with regard to disasters, what are the best fortification decisions for their road network? When I was in college, I thought I was going to be an econ PhD. That's what I was thinking I was going to do. But as I took math and econ classes for my double major, I fell in love with math because I could describe basically anything with math. And so I saw math as a way of moving between various different applications and disciplines, depending on what you want to do. I mean, math gave me power, essentially. I'm part of the Women in Math organization here. I'm on the e-board there. And so we're trying to help involve more women in math through the graduate students and undergraduate students. I went to actually a symposium in the winter, so between the fall semester and the spring semester this past year, and it was kind of like a professional development seminar for graduate students, and I really enjoyed that. They had a variety of workshops on things, you know, writing cover letters or writing, you know, posters to, you know, how do you apply for fellowships, etc. And I found the advice very useful. The really cool thing about the applied math program is that we have, you know, 140 plus associated faculty that the applied math students can go, you know, seek out as advisors. And so you have opportunities for more research projects that way as well. There's the Norbert Wiener Center for Harmonic Analysis. It's a really cool place that a lot of people are getting involved in. Definitely keep a lookout on the emails for various professional development events that are going on. They constantly have them, and I wish I could go to more. Definitely keep an eye out on that. I think making sure that you interact with people and really establish those friendships, because graduate programs are great here, but you're going to need a little bit of support. And I think just coming in with an open mind and realizing that there are definitely going to be hard times, but it is worth it at the end of the day. So I want to go work for basically an academic lab where I would apply mathematics directly to real life. So something like national labs, or I actually did an internship at Johns Hopkins Applied Physics Lab this past summer, and so I really enjoyed that as well. I would love to put together, start, you know, working on frameworks for disaster relief that are able to account for things like temporal shifts, like things over time, stochastic events that where we don't know what's happening, be able to involve differential equations. So basically, I want to be part of putting together a framework for disaster relief and how we do crisis management better. Thank you.